जे क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन. द टू एडजेसेंट साइड ऑफ रोम्बस आर 5x माइनस 3 एंड 2x प्लस 9. फाइंड x एंड हेंस फाइंड द साइड ऑफ रोम्बस. वी नो प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ रोम्बस, ऑल साइड्स आर इक्वल. देन फर्स्टली आई वांट टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ x. हाउ टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ x? 5x माइनस 3 इज इक्वल टू 2x प्लस 9. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस वी कैन फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ x. Can I solve J question? Students, you got J answer? Everyone turn on our video. Yes. K question I am going to explain. The diagonal of rhombus measures 16 centimeter, 30 centimeter. Find the side of the rhombus. There is one formula. Note down. Diagonal D1 square plus diagonal D2 square is equal to 4 into side square. This is very famous formula in mathematics. Diagonal D1 square plus diagonal D2 square is equal to 4 into side square. Now in K question you are observing the diagonal of rhombus measures 16 centimeter, 30 centimeter. Means in K question diagonal D1 is equal to, he has given 16 centimeter. Diagonal D2 is equal to 30 centimeter. We want to find out side of rhombus. What is side of rhombus? Side of rhombus means with the help of this formula we want to find out side of rhombus. Note down. D1 square plus D2 square is equal to 4 into side square. 4 into side square. D1 value is 16. 16 square. D2 value is 30. 30 square is equal to 4 into side square. 16 square, 256. 30 square 900 is equal to 4 into side square. 256 plus 900, 1156. 1156 divided by 4 is equal to side square. Implies that side square is equal to I want to do division. 4 2s are 8, 289. But I want to find out side. Side square is equal to 17 square. Side square is equal to 17 square. Yeah. 256 plus 900, 1156. Now 4 into side square, multiplication quantity becomes division. 1156 divided by 4 is equal to side square. Now side square is equal to 17 square. Side is equal to 17 centimeter. Side is equal to 17 centimeter. Side is equal to, because exponent are same, if bases are different, then we can say if exponent are same, base will be also same. Answer side is equal to 17 centimeter. This is the main formula. With the help of this formula, we can find out the answer. Right? If you have any here doubt, note down here. 1156 is equal to 4 into side square. Now 4 into means multiplication quantity becomes division. 1156 divided by 4 is equal to side square. Side square is equal to 289. Now 289 is the perfect square. D square is equal to D1 square plus D2 square is equal to 4 into side square. Yo, shit. Thank God. I got it. Yes. D1 square plus D2 square is equal to 4 into side square. What is D1 and D2? D1 and D2 are diagonals. With the help of direct formula, we can write the answer. This formula is very important formula. Where D1 and D2 is our diagonals. Where D1 and D2 are diagonals. Right. Yale question. In the rhombus, SUER, SU is equal to 5 cm. SU is equal to 5 cm, OR is equal to 3 cm, find the length of the diagonal SE. Draw this figure, everyone. Yes, U, E, R. This is point O, 3 cm. This is 5 cm. Some mentals are coming after 15 minutes. Yes, in this question, observe here. Already we know property of rhombus. All sides are equal. All sides are equal. Opposite angles are equal. Diagonal bisect each other at 90 degree. If a diagonal is bisecting, this length is 3 cm. This length also will be 3 cm. Now total length is 6 cm. Right, means UR is equal to, this is UR, UR is equal to 6 cm. I'm assuming let UR is equal to diagonal D1 is equal to 6 cm. Right, next he is asking find the diagonal SC. Diagonal SC is equal to, I'm assuming D2. D2 is equal to question mark. And side he has given 5 cm. Side of rhombus is equal to 5 cm. Just now I have given formula D1 square plus D2 square is equal to D1 square plus D2 square is equal to diagonal D1 square plus diagonal D2 square is equal to 4 into side square. This is the formula. We want to substitute with this value. D1 already he has given 6 square. D2 I want to find out is equal to 4 into side is 5 square. 6 square is 36. Plus D2 square is equal to 5 square is 25, 25 into 4, 100. Now D2 square is equal to 100 minus 36. 100 minus 36 is equal to 64. Now d2 square is equal to 64 is the perfect square, 8 square. Now diagonal d2 is equal to 8 centimeter. What is the value of d2? d2 is nothing but side SC, means diagonal SC. Hence, the length of diagonal. Hence, the length of diagonal. Hence, the length of diagonal SC is 8 centimeter. First note down, everyone. With the help of Pythagoras theorem also we can got it. One more method is there. What is that method? Listen carefully. Second method also. If you don't know formula, how to solve this question? Here we can, this is right angle triangle. This is right angle triangle. Hypotenuse is 5 centimeter. Base is 3 centimeter. Perpendicular I can find out. Okay. 5 square minus 3 square. Right. 16 means 4 will come. Now this length is 4, then total length will be 8 centimeter. That is easy question. With the help of Pythagoras theorem also, we can find out. This is the hypotenuse, this is the base. Perpendicular you want to find out. Pythagoras theorem is saying hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. Now base, firstly perpendicular square I want to find out. Perpendicular square is equal to hypotenuse square minus base square. 5 square minus 3 square, 25 minus 9, 16. 25 minus 9 is equal to 16. Now perpendicular square equals 16, perpendicular is equal to 6, 4. Now half length is 4, total length will be 8 centimeter. With the help of Pythagoras theorem also, we can find out this answer. I hope you got it. Right. Yeah, everyone note down M question. Everyone copy M question in the class notebook. Yes. Prove that diagonal AC of rhombus ABCD bisect angle A as well angle C. Prove that diagonal AC means firstly I want to draw rhombus. Everyone draw this rhombus first. Prove that diagonal AC bisects angle A as well angle C. This is note down angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4. And this is point, we can take any point, O point. Yes, firstly I'm talking about in triangle ABC. I'm talking about in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, we know property of rhombus, each and every sides, all sides are equal. Diagonal bisect each other at 90 degree. Yes. In triangle ABC, ABC means down to the triangle. In triangle ABC, AB is equal to BC. AB is equal to BC. Why? This is the property of rhombus, because all sides are equal in rhombus. Note down on the bracket, property of rhombus. Property of rhombus. Which property? All sides are equal. Now you are observing, students, angle 1 is equal to if these two adjacent sides are equal, then that adjacent angle also will be equal. Angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Understood? This figure observe here. If this is the figure ABC, if these two sides are equal, then this angle also will be equal. This is the property of angle opposite to the equal sides are equal. Note down. Angle 2 is equal to angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Why? Angles opposite. Angles opposite to equal sides. Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Note down, this is equation first. Now AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 4. If AD is parallel to BC, then only I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 4. Which angle is forming? Interior alternate angle or alternate interior angle, Z shape. Angle 1 is equal to angle 4. Alternate interior angle. Alternate interior angles. This is equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, equation 1 is angle 2 is equal to 4. And angle 1 is equal to 4. Right side are equal, then I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Because right side are equal means I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Our proof completed. Hence, AC bisects angle A. Everyone, first write down angle 1 is equal to angle 2. First write down, everyone. Hence, AC bisects angle A and angle C. It means you are observing here, AC is angle A is equal to angle C. If this is the bisector line, half of angle will be up, half of angle will be down. that is the bisector. Bisector means if one angle dividing into two equal part, that is called bisector angle concept. Suppose 90 degree is there, if I want to draw bisector angle, then 45 degree will be up and 45 degree will be down. Yes. If angle, that's why I am saying beta, if angle 1 is equal to angle C, angle 2, then I can say angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Because AC is the bisector line. AC is the bisector line. AC is the bisector line. That's why angle A and angle C, not L. Angle A is bisect to angle C. A means this complete angle is bisecting to complete C. If angle 1 is equal to angle 2, then this side also I can say angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Are you getting my point, student? This is angle 1 and 2, both are bisector. Then that's why we can say this, if half of angle is up, half of angle is down, then I can say AC is bisector of angle A and angle C. Right. Now keep adding properties of trapezium. Keep adding properties of trapezium. Keep adding properties of trapezium. Properties of trapezium. Properties of trapezium. Already each and every quadrilateral family I have explained previously. Now we are learning only properties of quadrilateral family. Draw figure right side. Draw figure right side, everyone. Don't repeat, this is not L, it is symbol of angle, not L. Slanting L is called, that is symbol of angle, not L, right? First property. First property. Adjacent angles are supplementary. Adjacent angle are supplementary. What is the meaning of trapezium? Trapezium is a quadrilateral with only one pair of parallel sides. You are observing, students, in this figure, AB is parallel to DC. What is the trapezium? Trapezium is a quadrilateral with only one pair of parallel sides. In this figure, AB is parallel to DC, but AD is not parallel to BC. If AB is equal to AB parallel to DC and AD is equal to BC, that is called isosceles trapezium. If two sides are parallel, other two sides are equal, other two opposite sides are equal, that is called isosceles trapezium. Again, I am repeating, listen carefully. What is trapezium? Trapezium is a quadrilateral with only one pair of parallel sides. AB parallel to DC, but AD is not parallel to BC. If AB is parallel to DC and AD is equal to BC, that is called isosceles trapezium. Isosceles means two sides are equal, that is called isosceles. Now down, first property, adjacent angles are supplementary. Adjacent angles are supplementary. Adjacent angle, I can take angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degree, or angle 2 plus 3 is equal to 180 degree, or angle 1 plus 4 is equal to 180 degree. One example I am writing on the bracket, note down. Angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degree. This is the first property. What is second property? If AD is equal to, if AD is equal to BC, if AD is equal to BC, that is called what? Isosceles trapezium. That is called isosceles trapezium. If AD is equal to, if AD is equal to BC, that is called isosceles trapezium. That is called isosceles trapezium. Keep on star point. Or trapezium is a isosceles. Or trapezium is an isosceles. Or trapezium is an isosceles if and only if. If and only if the base angles are congruent, the base angles are congruent. The base angle are congruent. This is very famous theorem you learn in the 9th class. How to prove this theorem? A trapezium is an isosceles if and only if the base angles are congruent. Means if this angle is equal to this, both the triangles are congruent. If both angles are congruent, then only it will form isosceles trapezium. Why? Because you are observing here, this AD is equal to BC, obviously that side, that angle also will be equal. It's a very famous theorem. You learn this proof in 9th class. All right. Thank you, class.